32 days? Really? Oh my God. Hey, all right, here, that's what. All right, Bobby. I knew you could do it, Bob. I knew you could do it, Bobby. I knew it. So how do you feel?
Very good. I shake a lot sometimes. But other than that, I'm pretty good.
Okay, well, yeah, you're going to have a lot of withdrawals, Bob. You know, different kinds. But but the main thing is, Bob, you got 32 days of sobriety under your belt. You know? And your body right now is just saying, thanks, Bob, you know? They really are. Every being, every cell within your body is screaming out, saying, thank you, Bobby. Yeah, keep it up, Bob. Andy Griffith, Andy would say, keep it up. And Andy's going fishing with his son, Opie. They're going down to the old fishing hole there with a can of worms, don't you know?
I like Andy Mayberry.
Well, who doesn't? I mean, that's all Americana right there, but that's all we need. That's all we need to get back to. And if we could all get back to the Andy Griffith time and mode of this country and the way it was, it'd be wonderful, wouldn't it? Wouldn't it be wonderful?
Yes, it would, Kevin.
Thank you very much, thank you. All right. I threw some free whistling for you guys. Of course, you probably shut me off by now, but that's all right. I'll continue. I gotta continue. On with the show. Here we go. Oh, there's lots of ways to build this wall, too. There really is. I talk about the wall, you know, in all honesty and stuff, but there really is. There is enough probably scrap steel in this country laying around that's just, and what's going to be done with it? Is it just going to completely rust away until rust to dust? Is it such a thing? Well, maybe. Because we got old tanks, we got old ships, we got all sorts of stuff out there, baby, that Donnie can have. Well, Donnie could have free for the crepe's sake, couldn't you? Junkyard, there's cars in the junkyards, there's all sorts of stuff out there that we could salvage and put towards Donnie's wall. That's right. And a lot of people don't understand. They think that this wall has to be up forever. It does not have to be up forever. It could be up for quite a while, but then again, that steel ain't going nowhere. And, you know, take it down when you need it, melt it down, make it, use it for our greedy purposes again, cars and crap and whatever. See, it's not going away. Yeah. But anyway, they don't look at it like that. You should really think about using our scrap metal, Forrest Gump. I don't hear about Forrest Gump. Miss Jenny. Anyway, Forrest Gump, he started his own ice cream company up. I don't know if you heard about that, but that's just it. You're not going to hear this stuff anywhere else. So obviously you probably did hear. Everything that I spiel out of my mouth, you guys probably never heard of before, or never will again probably, because when I built this place up from the ground up 3 years ago, I knew back then it was going to be just a one in a million type enterprise. There you go. I like that. Speaking of enterprise, that was the name of the ship. I had the Star Trek things here too. I was playing that later. Earlier, I mean. Well, it could have been later. I don't know. Anyway, what happened? Forrest Gump is going to start up his own ice cream company. But the people who make the decisions for him, in other words, the stockholder, shareholder, whatever, they seem to say that Donnie wanted to... Donnie... Jesus Christ. Buko Dinky Dow. Let's diddy him out, baby. Diddy him out. They told him, Forrest, that's fine that you had a new flavor, but they said we're gonna have to ixnay on the shrimp flavored ice cream. That's right. Yep. Can you imagine that? That's what he wanted to put out there. And so that ain't going nowhere. And I think he ought to come out with a flavor that his mom gave him, a good advice. I think he ought to have a flavor out there called Stupid Is and Stupid Does. I think he might have a little bit better luck there. And if you're in, yes, we're going to be having our new sponsor here pretty soon. It's the Huff and Puff store, Mary Jane and Smoky Paraphernalia. Yes, thank you. Yes. Yes, that stuff's coming. You know what it is. You can't stop it, baby. It's going to start rolling like a... Anyway, it's going to be pretty cool. Ben Gay's got its own... you people out there use Ben Gay. I know we do. You damn right we do. Yeah. Oh, geez. I wonder what group of people use more Ben Gay than any other. Let's see. Would it be boomers? Yep, that could very well be. Yep. Anyway, Bengay is coming up because there again, I have my people check with their people, and you're not going to hear this anywhere else again. Okay, Bengay is soon to come out with their product. Their Bengay is going to be for men. It's going to be coming. It's going to be smelling like Bengay. Yes, Bengay, and for the ladies, it's going to be smelling like Chanel Number 5. Now, what the hell's wrong with that? Nothing. Nothing. Who wants to put on that stinky shit? You know? Yeah. It almost burns your nose, that menthol-y crap they use. Okay, we touched on this base too, was the cost of one aircraft carrier, and this is no bullshit. This is real. This aircraft carrier is about 60-70% done. I want to say it's a brand new Kennedy or Ford. I can't remember. And these babies go for, at least this latest newest one's going upwards of about $13 billion, okay? We already have the mightiest fleet out on the oceans, the most ships, the most powerful Navy in the world. You know, we really don't need more aircraft carriers. Because, see, it's like a catch-22 in a way. You build more carriers, guess what's got to be on top of those carriers to make it all worthwhile? Well, you have to have more jets, and you have to have maybe 80 to 100 more jets on each ship. I'm not certain the amount. I would guess maybe at least 40 to 50 for sure, okay? And each one of those babies are running in at a cost of probably maybe $10 to $30 million, something like that. So you do the math. One ship with no plane, just scrap it out, take that money, and put it right in Adonis' wall. Bingo! Bada bing, bada boom, bada bang. Thank you. Thank you. That's right. Yeehaw is right. That's right. That's all you got to do. You want to cut corners? Yet again, you would still have the most powerful, largest Navy in the world, bar none. That is guaranteed, baby. I wanted some summer stuff here. We'll play a little summer stuff. No, I don't want that. What's this stuff? Aliens on the Mars. What the hell is that? I run a high class quality listening station here. I can't be having no stuff like that. Aliens on the Mars. Are you? No way. No way. I'm going to play this number 10. Okay, number 10, Rolling Stones Flashback. I'm going to be playing. You like it. All right. Let's sit back, guys, and we're going to be listening to a little bit of Rolling Stones, baby. Rolling Stones. That's right, baby. Rolling Stones. As soon as I can get this one up. Here we go, baby. Rolling Stones. Little Red Rooster, baby. Red Rooster. Woo! Hey!
Chrome, baby.
Woo! Wow!
I'm the Red Rooster, baby. Too late to crow.
Whoa! I got to crow, baby, all night long.
Woo!
You gotta love the Little Red Rooster, baby. I'm telling you what. Let's get down. Let's get down with that bad stuff, right? Okay, here we go. Where'd it go? Alright. Okay, baby, here we go. We're back at it. Alright, sit back and relax. Light up a J. Captain Boomer's on his way. He will take you through this day. That's right, baby. Okay, we got to find,